parents do. They all lie to their kids for their own good.
But other parents aren't lying, Ma. They believe in their children.
No, they don't.
So how do you not take that personally, even when it's from your own mother? It's funny when it's in a sitcom, but when it happens in real life, what do you do?
Yeah, not so funny then. Relationship coach Matt Townsend is here with ways to offset the offense.
Yes. You know what would help? Those eggs.
That would cure all
if
problems.
You did the eggs, I'm pretty sure they'd forget all about it.
They wouldn't remember anything. So much sugar there, you know?
So, okay, do you remember last time I was here? You were gone.
I was not here.
But it was a magical moment.
Oh, great. Recreate it for me.
Well, we were talking about moving past our mistakes, right?
Okay.
And I made this flippant remark about Darren's watch.
Which is so out of character.
Yeah, I can't totally imagine that.
And I made fun of his watch. I think we have a clip of it.
Okay.
Because we need to figure out how Darren can get over
one mistake, for example, if you look at Darren's watch, a really bright red watch is a pretty big mistake. But you know what, Darren? We're just going to learn from it.
We're never going to wear
that watch again. I don't want to point out the negative.
He's owning it.
It's jacked up. It's seriously messed. Okay? Anyway, let's learn from it.
That's pretty rough. That guy's a jerk.
He is.
So have you gotten over it?
I have. I picked up the pieces and moved on.
Didn't you start drinking?
Just that one afternoon of heavy drinking and it's over now.
Yeah,
one
binge. Added a few Easter eggs and he was fine.
He gained 12 pounds because of the watch coming out. But don't you know, some people, like, we make a flippant remark about someone's jewelry. That gaudy jewelry.
A watch is not jewelry, okay? It's just a timepiece.
Bling.
Yours is more like blom.
About the red blom.
We're supposed to be nice.
Am I still offending?
Okay. Yeah.
Anywho, we got to get over this because I feel bad for Darren. And so today we're going to talk about four keys to getting over, to not taking things personally.
Do you think people get offended too easily in this day and age? You do.
Well, yeah. I don't think we have anything else to do.
And let me ask a follow-up
question. So we get offended.
Do men or women get offended more easily than the other? Does one happen more than the other?
I think a lot more rolls off a man's back. In my business, I see a lot of people, and it seems that men tend to be able to forget and move on.
Get over it.
Get over it. But I think also it might be just, it's more personal to women. I mean, they're feeling the emotion of what was said. They're feeling, a lot of men maybe didn't even hear it.
Yeah, we're oblivious to it.
We don't even know what was said. I'm not dissing the man because I am one. But we got to get over it. So these four keys are the keys, things you can be doing to get over taking things personally, okay? Four rules. Rule number one. Are you ready for this one?
Ready.
You got to remember that you're the one that has the power. The minute you start taking offense to what everyone else is saying, you're giving everyone the power. You have to remember, you get to choose to get over something or not. We've talked about this. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but
words can never hurt me.
Yep, words or names will never hurt me. So apparently as kids, we knew that your words and your names can't hurt me. We knew we had the power as kids to not be hurt by you. You can beat on me all you want. You can use a stick and a stone to hurt me, but don't call me names because it won't matter because it just washes right off my back.
So you've got to hold on to your emotions.
And your power. You got to remember, it's a choice. If you're going to be offended, you have to carry that baggage and you got to keep carrying it the rest of your life. If you don't think it's a choice, then you're not even going to be able to do the next three things we're talking about.
Well, you know, but it is. It's such a personal thing. Someone's offending me. They're saying something that's offending me, my personality, my appearance, whatever it is.
Yeah, and it's not about you. That's the funny thing. It's not about you. When people say things that are offensive, that was my cackle. Every once in a while, I like to throw in a cackle for the people. It's not about you. The problem is we're all so kind of egocentric. We think everything's about us. We think that I don't have a parking place downstairs when I pulled up. That's bad. Why does KSL not have a parking place for me? Well, because it's not about you, Matt, quite honestly. But you know what?
That's a big one.
Well, think of it. When somebody says something offensive, it's usually because they're already hurting. Everyone has pain and junk, and when I offend you and I'm rude to you, it's just me trying to take my junk and throw it on you.
Wait, are you honestly saying that when you say something, I would normally get offended, that it's you, it's not me, it's
my
you?
Well, let's not go there, but my comment about your gaudy blog,
blong,
that was more about me and my sense of style than Darren. Is as if I said that his watch was ugly, as if it is just universally ugly, which I'm not saying it's not. But if I don't like it and I don't like his style and I offend you by that, I'm really talking about what I think is stylish.
Uh-huh.
Or if I make an offensive remark and like cut you down and put you down or whatever, it's probably because I got junk. I've got baggage. And if I hand you that baggage and you run with it for the next year, then you've just taken over my junk. It'd be better just instead realize it's not about you, and instead try to figure out, why does this person feel that my watch is ugly? Tell me what you think would have looked better.
So rule one and two kind of go hand in hand, because it's, I think realizing it's not about you gives you even more power.
It totally gives you power.
Don't you think?
Yeah, but you won't make that choice unless you know you have the power to make the choice.
Yeah.
Yep. So once I know I have the choice and the power, and I know that everything that people say about me isn't always about me, sometimes it's just about them, mm-hmm. it's always a reflection more of what they're thinking than what I am. Right? Because I know who I am, and I'm not just a red watch. The third thing is, though, in everything that people say, there's a little truth. And what we try to do is reject the truth immediately. We try to, but
the truth hurts. Sometimes.
It totally hurts. And
I mean,
you know what's so weird about it is it's still true. Even if it hurts like a mother, it's still true. And you can keep hating everybody that keeps telling you the truth, but really what you hate about this situation is that they're speaking truth. And it's truth that you already know, and you've been working on for 4 years. I'm trying to get rid of the gut. You don't need to bring it up.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, that anger really tends to be more about us. So there's power when somebody does give you a little feedback. You could have just said, what is it about my watch that's maybe a little out there? That Matt would actually bring that up. Is there any truth? Well, yeah, it's huge. It's huge.
It's
so you
red.
Could say, it's huge red watch on my little white arm. It just, it's the contrast that kills.
I've been sitting here trying to think of another example, Darren.
He's bending my arm.
Am I being more offensive?
My little white arm.
Hey, but remember, you get to choose about your little white arm. I don't mean
it's
little.
It's not about
your
you.
Your long, manly white arm. Like there, right there. Crossed like a little girl right there.
Oh, my God.
You know what? I think I'm in trouble.
Okay, it's
the
not
sugar.
About me. It's
this
not
is
about
the
me.
Sugar.
I'm remembering.
Okay, don't ever give me sugar before my segment.
Mental now you're
note.
Blaming Becky.
Yeah, Becky.
Bring her into this.
Stupid sugar pusher.
All right, next rule.
No, I don't mean you're stupid. I really don't. I've got to get off the set. Last rule.
Is there anybody he will not offend before the segment ends?
I'm not going to offend the student body.
Okay.
I'm not going to offend the audience. Last one. Get your confidence from your character. Not everyone else's comment.
I like this one a lot.
The power is in you, and your confidence comes from the fact that you're a good, decent person. You always have been. You don't get your confidence from the blong you wear. You get your confidence from the fact that you're a good, decent guy that tries hard, that's personal.
So in those vulnerable moments, though, when you're feeling attacked, yeah. I mean, we hope we've done rule one yeah. through three, but how do you, any tricks to digging deep and finding that confidence?
I remember what I'm really about. What am I really about? What are the principles I really want to guide my life by? I'm an honest, decent, smart, fun, caring guy. That's what I'm about. It doesn't matter what she thinks I'm about.
And I love number two. If it's something, it's not me, it's you. Just put it all yeah. back on you.
And
throw
then the
you
power
the
is then go into them and try to figure out, why is it you think that? So if somebody says you're stupid, and you know you're not, you've got a degree. Then go back and say, you know what, that was a little hard on me. Tell me what you mean. Where are you going with that? Okay. And then try to understand.
You know what's interesting?
What?
My grandpa had a watch just like yours.
See? Your grandpa's brilliant.
Matt and his grandpa watching his gut are having a date night coming up. And we would love to hear more
yeah.
about that.
Bring
Matt.
Your blong. It's Friday, April 29th. This is a really good one. If you have any friends or you know anybody that argues with their partner about money, this is the date night for you. It's Friday the 29th, 7 o'clock to 9 o'clock. We laugh. It's tons of fun. Give us a call, 747-2121.
Finances is the topic?
Talking to your partner about
one.
Finances.
Okay.
Yeah. No sugar. There will be no sugar at this event.
Ever again. Thanks,
okay.
Matt.
Thanks, guys.
Speaking of sugar in the candy.